Their reaction when I could actually answer the question was like, oh, but so you really are a fan. Hello, my name is Emma and my quest is bringing more diversity through recruiting. I come from France, really near to Geneva. It's when I arrived at EPFL that I realized being female in this kind of environment is different. I counted on the list of students the number of misses written. It was 36 over 380. That's 9%. There was some positive things, such as just you can come in however you want, dressed in class, no one will say anything. But also sometimes you feel not seen or not heard. You have to justify some of your results or stuff like this because the people just don't trust you. So the more diverse the people are, the more comfortable it is for all of the groups. I mean, if it were the case for women, you can imagine for people of color, what was the experience? In the past, I've had moments where I expressed that I was a NBA fan or a Formula One fan, which is actually true. And people would react by just seemingly asking a couple of questions, two to three, to verify that I had indeed the knowledge of what's going on right now. And their reaction when I could actually answer the question was like, oh, but so you really are a fan? And I was like, yeah, this is what I said. I am a fan. I do get mad about inequality. Like, have you heard the differences of prices for the Football World Cup if you are the winning team from between men and women? Like, why is it so different? I'm now a data scientist for the human resources in Swisscom. When you start measuring diversity, diversity in a whole is very difficult. So the standpoint we took is, can we compare our current team to what would be the most diverse team possible? So if you have three people, the most diverse team in terms of language, for example, one speaking Swiss German, one French, one Italian maybe. And from now we can look at what is actually in our team and compare to this ideal, most diverse team, how far they are from each other. That's our diversity score. Basically our brain is used to recognizing patterns and putting people into boxes. And to me, equality is refraining our brain to doing those boxes and just allowing everyone to do what they want to do. My goal for the future is that feminism, racism is not a topic anymore. And I firmly believe that it can be achieved through education beginning at the youngest age. I mean, right now we want role models and visibility so that people can see it's possible. But if you don't put barriers from the very young age, you know it's possible, and you will go after it if you want to. And this is where you say, "Way!"